Honourable Minister, Director, DG Education and Culture, people from the Commission, speakers, delegates, guests, colleagues and friends. It is my great pleasure to welcome you to the conference on the state of digital education. I would particularly like to thank those of you who have travelled from afar to join us today. Our ministry's portfolio spans both education and employment. At times, that is a privileged position to be in that we are obliged to support and accommodate on a daily basis the dialectic between stakeholders in the two spheres. Education has become synonymous with learning outcomes, which are increasingly related to the acquisition of new skills. At times, however, this also risks positioning education as something which must contribute to employment at all costs, as opposed to, say, learning for personal empowerment or the personal development of young people into the 21st century citizens. We have found it more logical to approach this dilemma within a lifelong learning context. The notion of a career for life has long gone. People need to keep reskilling and relearning at different stages in their life. It also means that the needs of learners must inevitably be positioned before the needs of the education institution, something that policymakers need to remember on a day-to-day basis like a mantra. Technology poses both opportunities and challenges to policymaking. Within ministries in many member states, ICT people and pedagogy people, policymakers, people working on national curricula, have traditionally tended to work in silos. That's not just something that is only pertinent to a ministry. The same applies to colleges and higher education institutions. Separate departments, different people with different skill sets. The results have often been very perspectively. Success tends to be gauged by the number of devices in a classroom and ambiguous bandwidth, as opposed to new approaches to teaching and learning. These variables related to digital infrastructure are, of course, important. They address key performance indicators for departments and are also easily comprehensive within a new context. Like ministries in other member states, we have to ensure that classes have access to whiteboards, ubiquitous bandwidth and Wi-Fi. Rather than continue to invest in repairing hardware, we have introduced bring your own device schemes to provide teachers with flexibility while remaining vigilant on the impact on security and data protection. We are deploying tablets for young learners after concluding a significant pilot project to understand the technological and pedagogical challenges and opportunities in deploying tablets and other mobile education devices in the classroom. We are setting up sustainable ICT organization structures, both within the ministry and the state schools. We need to have sustainable policies and procedures in place that can ensure that technology is responsive to the rapidly changing educational landscape, and particularly the need of our students. Yet, when it comes to the particularities of pedagogy, to rethink curriculum, to even rethink the classroom, that is where things get very challenging. It is very easy to be reminded that things in education have to take time. Yet, try to explain to young people with access to the internet and daily access to alternative modes of teaching and learning, or to parents, for the matter. I will focus on three initiatives in Malta, which we have kick-started to better align technology to key educational challenges, and which may have some resonance with this audience. Some 15 months ago, we set up a technology in education task force with a direct reporting line to my office. This is a multidisciplinary team constituted of ministries, CIOs and Government's Information Technology Agency, but also people working with the curriculum, e-learning, and overall educational strategy. The task force is not some consultative talk shop, but a key component of my ministry's operations. Key projects which have an ICT component are vetted by the task force. We believe education can be made available to a broader audience at a much lower cost and potentially provide higher quality instructions at the same time. The task force is addressing issues ranging from content to be deployed on tablets for young students in classes, to explore how students learn in real time by taking advantage of the greater variety, volume, and velocity of data. A green paper has been published on digital literacies. The task force is also looking at how teacher productivity may be increased, freeing up valuable time from tasks such as grading and testing to planning and delivering quality teaching. Used diligently, technology can be a powerful tool for educators to reimagine learning experience. The classroom of the future needs is not some futuristic lab, but must involve the redesign of classrooms at active, deeper, and more personalized learning spaces, supported by the mindful use of technology. As policymakers in Malta, we need to ensure that the commitment to improve infrastructure is supplemented by a corresponding commitment to digital pedagogy and support environments. The second initiative is the newly established National Skills Council. We are keen to close the skills gap through creative, real-life solutions to the fundamental challenges faced by 21st century learners and those who seek to employ them, including a lack of well-trained teachers and accessible technology infrastructure. The Ministry will work with its social partners to develop pragmatic solutions for the mutual benefit of learners and employers. The Skills Council also brings together private companies and education providers to shape the future of adaptive and personalized learning through technology. The third initiative is a partnership between my Ministry and the Commonwealth of Learning in Vancouver, which recognizes Malta's key position as an interface between the Commonwealth educational paradigm and that of the European Union. The newly established Commonwealth Centre for Connected Learning will operate as a knowledge hub for a global network of groups, agencies, institutions, educators and activists interested in the rapid deployment of programmes for connected learning in the Commonwealth and the EU. The centre's focus will be a praxis as opposed to policy, brokering opportunities for organizations and nation states that subscribe to the key tenet of openness in education. The centre will be launched formally during the OER regional consultation meeting in Malta on the 23rd, 24th February 2017 this year. To conclude, Malta has frequently been used as an island lab for the rapid deployment of emerging technologies. I am old enough to remember the old Nokia slogan, connecting people. We Maltese have a great tradition of being great networkers. I hope this conference will provide many opportunities for you to work together and beyond the 2 days of this conference. Thank you very much.